Next speaker is Justin Schwartz.
Schwartz here in the Spring Valley Fire Department. So there's some commonalities. As the board, you're all community members. And you volunteer your time such as we do. So Dr. Wilcott, you and I have something in common. I'm a graduate of Fordham University, 1975, class of 75. As part of the City of New York teachers program, licensed in the state of New York K-6, and currently still licensed in New Jersey and New York. And I teach at Temple Beth Abraham, where I serve as a rabbi for the Hebrew High School. But the reason I'm here is about a thing that's dear to my heart. And I think, Dr. Wilcott, this is really for you. To understand, I don't know how much was really explained and the intensity that is here, that has been in this community back the way you went. I'm also part of the Illegal Housing Task Force. And the passion now that I'm going to do is because we had a fatal fire this morning in Central Nine. And an illegal housing, single family home, which has four families in it, and the one occupant died. Now, what does illegal housing have to do here in the school? I shall make that case. Repeated requests since November 2013 from Assemblyman Ken Zabrowski finally bore fruit some almost 2 years later, January 28, 2015, when the Secretary of State served notice to the town of Ramapo, as well as the village of Spring Valley, that they have not complied with the minimum standards of fire and safety codes, as well as certificates of occupancy through the town and village. Department of State Building Codes Director Ramapo had also advised during that investigation that the New York State Education Department finding non-public schools which are located in the town of Ramapo have not filed annual fire inspections required by the Education Law 807-A. And as of today, they still haven't complied. On August 10, 2015, some 8 months later, newly appointed Department of Education Commissioner Mary Ellen still writes to the Secretary, and this is what she said. Assistance in addressing the serious concerns about the health, safety of the students in a non-public school, as well raising questions about the accuracy of the annual fire and safety inspections submitted by those same schools. So, either the fox is guarding the hen house or the wolves in sheep's clothing are infiltrating the flock. Let's examine some of the players here in the room. Mr. Charles, you're a current town employee, former town planning board, and also, as was stated earlier, you're the councilwoman Brenda Logan's husband. Mr. Hopstein is a Spring Valley zoning board member, as well works in the town of Ramapo. And your illustrious treasurer, Israel Beer, who I've seen many times at the Zoning Board of Appeals. And the reason for me here is at your last town hall meeting in Spring Valley. So, pictures, or they say, is a thousand words. So, in the best place, your East Ramapo school bus was parked on the parking. It was right there on the sidewalk doing business hours. That's not so. State education haven't been certified, Dr. Wilcott. And why, and Mr. Klein moves on his way out, fails to understand that. So besides the pictures and the pictures of the trailers, I want to serve everyone Not a subpoena, so don't run. Very good. As we came in here, you duly noted the fire exits, and I applaud you for that, because that's the right way to do it. But not only has this board administration failed in the educational opportunities to the non-public schools, that's not what I'm here to address, but it allows outrageous conditions detrimental to the health and safety of the students of these schools. And since we're essentially focused solely on the students' children, this doesn't even begin to speak to the safety of my men under my command and the local firefighters that may come in, as well as the first responders. These non-public school students are commonly crammed into illegal, sometimes unsafe, non-certified education trailers, alleged to be temporary, defined as one-year use, and some of them have been in existence for over 3 years. Single-family homes, as we said, our apartments are now used as single schools as well, and now what happens, also they're rife with health, safety, and sanitary code violations. So I can go on and on, give you a lot more statistics. But let me just leave you with one. The fatal fire in the Lady of Angels School, which is a private school, started as a small trash fire in the basement. Fire then raced up to the main stairway, trapped students in the corridor and the rooms on the third floor. A sad footnote. Many students were found seated at their desks, heads down, as if they were praying. 295 of those. So each of these fires led to improvements which benefit school children all over North America. Exit drills are mandatory, construction practices according to code, which is non-existent here in the town and the village. More school inspections in most places, again, this is not done here, based on the state report. And since January 28, 2015, there's another one that just went out on October 6th, and still nothing has been done. It's a shame that so many children have to pay the penalty for the sins of the adults who did not know, care about fire safety issues. And do you really need to add another death to the lives of the children who already were martyred and we learned some deep lessons? Unlike those situations mentioned, we know better. Shouldn't we do better? Thank you. Let me just leave with one, since I don't want anyone to think I'm anti-Semitic. Old Testament, we just read Genesis. Just give me two seconds. I'm not going on.
Please. We have a pause.
Just give me a second, and I promise you I will. Just two. One is when you teach a woman, you teach a family, and you have there, you teach a nation. And that's going to be a tribute to the new incoming superintendent. The Old Testament. I'm like Noah, I'm telling you the flood is coming. Please, Dr. Wolcott, I heard you in the beginning. You want respect, and I think that's great for us. Our fire department doesn't want to tolerate it. You want the respect. My board members should not have done what he did, and just Think of the safety of those kids, because I promise, if God forbid something happens, you're not going to like what happens.
Woo!